Hachette Audio presents Cosmic Health. Unlock your healing magic with astrology, positive psychology, and integrative wellness. Written by Jennifer Racioppi. Read by Exi Sands and Jennifer Racioppi. Accompanying this program is a Mac and PC compatible PDF of supplementary materials.
To the Earth, Sun, and Moon with devoted humility. Preface. Before there was Earth, love, death, night, day, or light, there was chaos. Alternately described as a goddess, a shapeless nothingness, and a mix of the elements. Chaos gave birth to two children, Erebus, the unfathomable depth where death dwells, and night. Surrounded by a terrifyingly blank and boundless abyss, night nonetheless placed a wind-borne egg into the arms of Erebus. With time, love burst forth, bringing order and beauty to the bottomless confusion all around. Love then created light, and with it, radiant day. At long last, almighty Earth, also known as Gaia, came into being. A physical container of solid ground, Gaia possessed an equally powerful personality that shifted and changed, interacted and reacted. She was and remains almighty, yet tender, formidable, yet fragile. She, along with her lineage, lives on all around us and also inside us. She and her ancestors remain a part of you, me, and all of us. For too long, we have been taught to fear, critique, and tuck away life's chaos. Yet in doing so, we forget its immense power to transform us, our health, our lives, as well as the world we live in. While chaos may seem dark and daunting, as the time of chaos surely was, when we dismiss chaos, we forego the opportunity to give birth to love, light, radiance, and abundance of every imaginable kind. We unnecessarily dim our own magic. As we dive into this journey, I ask that you, like chaos herself, resist the temptation to hide and reject your unique brand of chaos and instead embrace it as a sacred invitation into your own cosmic health.
Introduction. Unable to stand, I crawled to the phone and dialed 911. Within minutes, my 97-pound body was strapped onto a stretcher, and ambulance sirens began echoing through the streets, broadcasting my race to the emergency room. The excruciating abdominal pain that had made me buckle over just minutes earlier had not yet let up. Equally torturous was the anxiety roiling within, consuming what little energy I had left. It was a hot July day at the Jersey Shore, just 6 weeks after my 18th birthday. While my friends enjoyed the summer sun on the beach, I spent my days, which soon became months, in and out of hospital beds. Weak, depleted, and profoundly unprepared for the journey ahead of me, I drifted through a dark fog of agonizing pain, sleep that failed to relieve my crippling fatigue, and depression that only worsened with wakefulness. My diagnosis and its gravity felt undeniable and terrifying. Aggressive ovarian cancer wreaked havoc on my young, small frame, or so they told me. In some ways, the diagnosis made sense to me. After years of brutal cramps, chronic depression, and menstrual dysfunction, years during which my doctor repeatedly told me I was a normal teenager with normal hormonal imbalances, I felt a small measure of relief from having my intuition validated. As I long suspected, I wasn't just a normal teenager. I'd taken some combination of antidepressants and the pill for years, yet the extreme suffering caused by my menstrual cycle, which had sometimes forced me to stay home from school, skip the athletics that I loved, and forgo the social chaos of teen life, persisted. My symptoms were anything but typical. That had been clear to me, and now, at long last, it was clear to my doctors too. And it was cancer, which is to say incredibly daunting. As I underwent an array of procedures and surgeries at various hospitals, I couldn't foresee how volatile yet enlightening my health challenges would become. I didn't yet know that after undergoing surgery to remove the bowling ball-sized tumor from my left ovary, my initial diagnosis would be rescinded. Instead of ovarian cancer, a year later I'd learn I had endometrial cancer. The cancer was ultimately removed, and with it my ovaries, uterus, cervix, and fallopian tubes. Not yet 20 years old, I was forced to undergo a radical hysterectomy and face the fact that I would never have biological children. The morning after that surgery, the doctor handed me a yellow, football-shaped pill and told me I'd have to take it every day for the next 30 years. That pill contained the estrogen my body could no longer produce. Despite the synthetic hormone supplementation, the absence of reproductive organs to supply my system with natural estrogen forced my body into menopause, literally overnight. Who at age 20 thinks about the symptoms and implications of menopause? I wasn't remotely prepared for what was to come. Terrified and distressed, I felt completely alone. Looking back, I now see that I wasn't alone. Even at my lowest of low points, I never was. So many of the women I now work with have their own stories of trauma, disease, heartache, and depression. For years, which sometimes turned into decades, they lived lives punctuated with that same deep soul ache and strong yet muted whispers from inside themselves. Something is off. This isn't working. Listen to me. Please listen. Like me, so many women have also had their intuitive knowing repeatedly invalidated by external authority figures. So many of them, like me, have taken themselves and their health to the brink, only to realize that living the body and soul nourishing lives they yearn for means ending their reliance on the next quick fix, miracle pill, practice plan, or belief system. They too have faced the fact that our individual and collective pursuits of the one big change, the spiritual practice, the diet change, and so on, isn't taking us anywhere we want to go. Instead, we must assume a radical level of responsibility for our health, not just physical, but emotional and spiritual too. We must find more authentic and comprehensive ways to heal. Only that kind of all-encompassing, holistic well-being can support the hopes and dreams we're committed to realizing. For me, the recognition that I needed to take charge of my whole health came after my hysterectomy. In the anxiety-ridden months that followed my final surgery, in the middle of my college years, I moved to the West Coast. There in the late 1990s, while working as a waitress, I was introduced to a wide array of alternative health and spiritual practices. These mind-body-spirit practices became the foundation of the reclamation of my body, my health, and my life. One pivotal day at Lake Tahoe, I was fortunate enough to find my first spiritual mentor, Debbie LaFay, whose petite frame and rhythmic voice belied her powerful yet odd-sounding wisdom. As she gave me a life-changing tarot reading, I felt a primal tug inside me. We had never met before, and social media didn't exist yet, so she possessed no concrete knowledge of my past. Yet this fairy-like creature named my experience so accurately, it almost felt invasive. Did I dare trust her guidance? Would I really experience the healing I desperately needed by claiming a relationship to cyclical living and working with lunar rhythms? I would, according to Debbie. In those early years, my inner knowing, that fuzzy yet tangible sixth sense we call intuition, often yanked at my science-loving intellect. What was real? What was pure unhinged woo-woo? What was wisdom passed down through generations only to be submerged and dismissed in the name of reason, logic, and all things patriarchal? Debbie taught me that the phases of the moon mirror the menstrual cycle and that by strategically keying into the moon's cadence, I could connect to the cycle I had lost when I sacrificed my ovaries to survive cancer, a cycle I never knew how to honor due to hormonal dysfunction. It was a fascinating dive into a new realm of understanding that ultimately pulled me in multiple directions. Then, in 2001, while studying at San Francisco State University, I had the honor of meeting renowned trauma expert Dr. Peter Levine. Inspired by his work, I went into therapy and experienced firsthand the transformative power of healing trauma through his somatic experiencing method, which addresses PTSD through a combination of physiology and psychology. Continuing to integrate moon work into my process, my healing slowly but surely unfolded at the intersection of alternative wellness, non-traditional spirituality, and evidence-based protocols. Years later, I became certified as a yoga teacher and then as an Ayurvedic nutritionist. I went on to become a certified integrative health coach with a specialty in behavior change at Duke Integrative Medicine. I also studied and apprenticed with leaders in positive psychology and resilience pedagogy, Dr. Maria Sirwa and Dr. Tal Ben-Shahar, serving as their teaching assistant.
With each new layer of knowledge and experience, my intellect-based skepticism melted away, and I saw how misguided my assumptions had been. Astrology, spirituality, and integrative medicine don't each exist in a vacuum. They are aligned with and connected to science. As my understanding deepened, I discovered that these disciplines are also powerfully connected to one another. Not only did my studies and ongoing practice improve my physical health, but I also began to experience a deep sense of integration within me. I learned that I am both intuitive and scientific, spiritual, as well as brass tacks, what I've since termed lunar logic. This union of science and magic allowed me to accept and embrace all of me, and in the process, create a life that was aligned with my natural tendencies and the rhythms of the moon that lived inside me. Even now, that growing sense of well-being, while never perfect, is continually reflected back to me through my resilience and my ability to move through difficulty with grace and stamina. Thanks to this work, over the past decade plus, I have had the honor of privately coaching hundreds of highly ambitious clients and supporting many more through my online platform on their healing journeys as they pursued their life goals without burning out. It brings me profound joy to help them achieve greater health, well-being, and success on their own terms. We do this by honoring the biological and cosmic rhythms that guide their lives, developing a deeper understanding of self through their astrology charts and coaching while integrating simple but powerful mind-body practices. With consistency, they experience the profound sense of confidence and calm that comes from knowing, whatever comes next, I've got this. I'm so excited to share this rich body of work with you. Before we dive in, let's take a quick tour of cosmic health, beginning with an introduction to the core concept. Introducing cosmic health. Cosmic health is at the intersection of cutting-edge research and ancient wisdom, marrying astrology with evidence-based science to create holistic well-being. As a healing path, it honors our individuality, our role in the universe, nature, and the seasonality of life while amplifying emotional, spiritual, and physical health. Let's break this down a little more. Astrology studies the correlation between the celestial bodies and events here on Earth. It sheds light on how everyone and everything is connected. By defining the multidimensional significance of our moment of birth through astrology, we gain access to a map that defines our potential. When we then marry that knowledge to the modern evidence-based science of positive psychology and integrative wellness, we can unlock our most natural expression of health, well-being, and happiness.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.